You guys, it's the big reveal day for my winter sew along. I am so excited to show you my finished windbreaker. If you have followed along this past week, then you know some of the thoughts I have on the pattern already, but let's just go over everything. The pattern is described as an unlined jacket with shaped yoke and sleeve. It has a separating zipper, shaped inseam front pockets, elasticized sleeve opening, and drawstrings with stoppers at the hood opening and shaped hemline. The wrong side of the fabric will show, and view A has a contrast hood and sleeves. To be honest, I wasn't prepared for the complexity of this pattern, but I'm getting ahead of myself. Let's start at the very beginning. Picking my size was a breeze. It's pretty roomy. It's designed to be pretty roomy at the bust and waist and semi-fitted at the hip. So I ended up having to grade between three sizes, which is pretty normal for me in big four patterns. My hip actually came in a smidge larger than the largest size of the pattern, so I had to extend the hip line past the pattern. But it was only by a little bit, so it wasn't that big of a deal. I point that out just because I don't necessarily consider myself a plus size sewist, so anytime any of my measurements don't fit within the finished measurements of a garment, I just like to point that out. Now, for the sewing. What a beast! What you can't really see in the model pictures, and I didn't really notice in the line drawings, is that angled corner where the yoke transitions to the sleeve. If you've ever done like a 90-degree angle in a pattern before, then you know that that is no joke. Not only that, but that shaped seam along the front is not for the faint of heart either. Neither of these details are impossible, and they certainly shouldn't be deal breakers, but they do require a bit of finesse. I checked the website again, and it says that the pattern is rated average in terms of difficulty. I don't know that I agree with that. I'd call it more of an advanced pattern personally, just because there's a lot of easing in, and that angled seam is rather tricky. There are some great details in this pattern, other than the two things I just mentioned. First, the shape of the hood. As you can tell, it was pretty windy when I filmed this, and the hood is not blowing off my head. That is one of my pet peeves, and this one passes the test. The drawstrings are also great. I love the large casing that houses them. I ended up using shoestrings for mine. They come in a ton of colors, widths, and lengths, and are very affordable compared to the specialty sewing notions like cording. Finally, I adore how the front pockets are built into the shaped seam. That was a pleasant surprise that I didn't see coming. They are not super deep. My hand does not fit in them like flat. I have to curl my fingers. But the construction of them makes up for that in my mind, and if I turn my phone sideways, it fits in there, so I'm gonna call it kind of a wash. Some good and some bad about the pockets. The fabric I used was this slub ripstop from fabric.com. It is perfect for this type of jacket. It comes in eight different colors, including the one I used, which is called maroon. It's described as a medium weight ripstop coming in at just under 6.5 ounces. I feel like this is the perfect weight. It's definitely not flimsy, but it also still has the movement that you want in an activewear jacket like this one. It's extra wide, 62 inches to be exact, so you can buy a little bit less than the pattern calls for. I bought 2.5 yards and ended up with about half a yard left over. And there you have it. Everything I have to say about the Lisette Windbreaker pattern. If you didn't participate in the sew along, I hope that you will consider it after seeing my finished jacket. It was a really fun, challenging make, and I am thrilled with how it turned out. But that is going to do it for me today. Thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you all very soon. Bye!